What do we mean, or let's say not we, what the word of God mean to believe in the name of Jesus? When we say we believe in the name of Jesus, is it simply to shout at the top of our voice, in the name of Jesus, when we pray, in the name of Jesus? Is that what it means? When we say we believe in the name of Jesus, or when the word of God says, at the name of Jesus, everything should bow, whether in heaven or earth, under the earth, does it mean that we should be going to the street of the world and be shouting the name of Jesus, the name of Jesus? Is that what it means? It's just like when we say believe in Jesus. Does it mean when you believe in Jesus, then it simply said, Jesus, I believe that you are God, you are the Son of God? Or somebody will say, Jesus, even the Father. We believe that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Is that what it just simply means to believe in Jesus? But Jesus asked the disciple, who do you think men say I am? He didn't say, what do you think they believe that I am? He said, what do you say they say? And what do you also say? So there's a difference between knowing that Jesus is the Son of God and believing in him. To believe in him is simply to believe that what he is saying is the truth. That you believe in the gospel. Believing in the gospel. When we believe in the gospel, then we believe in Christ. Of course, first we have to know who he is and believe who he is. But even right now in our Christian churches, they're preaching, they are not telling us that even Jesus is the Son of God. They say he's the Father. So they are even not trying to let us even believe who Jesus is. Because who Jesus is what we are. That is why God sent his Son. That faith in him, in his Son, if we believe in his Son, then we'll be saved. Not believe in him, God. Believe in his Son. Believe in his Son. God so loved the world, so give his only begotten, that anyone who believes in him, in the Son, will be saved. Anyone who don't believe in the Son will not be saved. So if somebody tells you that Jesus is the Father and you believe in the Father, you can't be saved, because you have to believe in the Son. John chapter 3 verse 16 to 18, that's what Jesus preached. John chapter 3 verse 16 to 18. Now if you go down to from verse 34 going up, John the Baptist said the same thing, that anyone who believes in the Son has the testimony himself. If you don't believe, you don't have that testimony. John chapter 3, 16 to 18, and from verse 33 downwards. And then 1 John chapter 5 says similar thing. Now, Apostle John was once a disciple of John the Baptist, so he was preaching exactly what John the Baptist was preaching. 1 John chapter 5, from verse 9 to 12. In fact, verse 12, it says, he that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God hath not life. So you have to have the Son of God, Jesus Christ, Son of God, not the Father. So you have to know the Father and know the Son. John chapter 17, verse 3, saying that the eternal life is to know the true God and Jesus Christ he has sent. So you can't say that Jesus the Father and expect to have life. You can't have life. But what we are discussing is the name of Jesus. What does it mean? It's very simple. When somebody said, believe in my name, if you believe in my name, you will cast out devils. You will speak with new tongues. You will take up serpents. If you drink any deadly to draw hurt you, you shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Those who believe in the gospel, in my name, they are going to do that. So first of all, you have to believe in the gospel and then believe in the name of Jesus. These two things are very important. When we believe in the gospel, what we believe in is that faith in the gospel makes us the sons of God. So when you believe in the gospel, it means you have become the son of God. That's what it means. The gospel makes you the son of God. And when you believe in the name of Jesus, when these two combine, then you will be on top. Then you are ready to cast every devil away, and they will go away. So first of all, when we believe in the gospel, we have come the Son of God. But then we have to know what it means to believe in his name. What does it mean? John chapter 1 verse 12 says that those who receive him, that's receive the gospel, it gives them the power to become the sons of God. God, the power to become the sons of God is in the gospel. The gospel is the power of God. That brings that. Romans 1:16. So when we receive the gospel, we receive the power. So he said, as many as receive him, he gave them the power. That's by the gospel, to become sons of God. Even those who believe in his name. So the same power, even, or and, those who believe in his name. So the two should go together. And then we are asking, what does it mean to believe in the name of Jesus? It's very simple. When you are working for the government, let's say you're a minister or head of an institution, before we go to that, this worldly example, let's go to what is in the Bible. In Matthew chapter 8, from verse 5, there was a centurion who came to Jesus for ask him to come and heal his servant at home. And Jesus, okay, let's go. He said, but you don't need to come. Just speak the word. Because I'm a centurion. When I say to this one, sit, he sit, he will sit. When I say to this one, stand, he will stand. Jesus, when Jesus heard that, that thing the man was using to explain why he should speak the word, why Jesus should speak the word, he marveled. Jesus marveled, himself marveled. He said, I've not seen such faith in Israel. You people will sit here and think you are sons of Abraham and go to hell while people from nations will go to enter into the kingdom of heaven. Sit down with Abraham. Say heaven. That's what he said. But sometimes Matthew confused heaven and kingdom of heaven, kingdom of God. Why? Because Matthew was a typical Jew. He doesn't even understand what called kingdom of God. So most of the time he mixed them. So sometimes when we are reading from Matthew, you can also be confused like him, because the Jews actually were not people given to know of the kingdom of God. They will know it when Christ returns. What they can understand is the kingdom of heaven. They find it even difficult to understand that also. So Matthew was saying that the centurion, that place of centurion, Jesus was telling him that, well, because that faith that the man had, Jesus marveled. And he said, well, he used kingdom of heaven, Isaac and Jacob, in verse 11, Matthew chapter 8. Now, why was Jesus marveling and said it was a great faith? He mentioned that there's not such great faith. Great faith. It's simply because he says, centurion is saying that I have a delegated authority and power from Caesar. Because the centurion is a captain of 100 army and military officers put under him. So he has that delegated authority and power from Caesar over those 100 army officers. So when he wants them to go for operation anywhere, he gives them instruction, they will go. Why? Not because he, the centurion, is just a very powerful person, but because of the name of Caesar on that man. The fear is on the name of Caesar. If the man is fired today by Caesar, nobody will listen to him. He can shout the name of Caesar, but nobody will listen to him. When they find out that Caesar has sacked him and he's no more a centurion. So the power is the name of Caesar that the man is working with. The man didn't have to tell the soldiers, hey, in the name of Caesar, go and do this. No. The people know that Caesar has appointed him. If they make any disobedience, if they cause any disobedience, if trying to disobey him, they know they are going to be punished. It's very same like for somebody, you are working with somebody in the company and they make the person maybe a foreman, or they make him a manager over a department. Everybody will listen to the person with some kind of fear. Why? because he's representing the authority of the company, and he can let that they even give you warning or even sack you. Why? Because when they say, ah, this guy is not obeying my instructions, they call that they don't want to work because the company has put the man there as the representative of the management. So everybody, the moment they say, well, this is the foreman, everybody will stand to be afraid. Why? Because the name of the company is on that man. So the words you speak is in the authority and power of the company. Let's also go to the world. In the government of the world, if someone is working for the government, he's a minister or he's head of an institution, a police officer, an army officer, or security agent, a customs officer, whatever, a council officer, community, a governor. Because the power of the government is conferred upon the person, he has a delegated power from the government, the president of the land, everybody is afraid of his instructions. The moment the person is maybe nobody, the moment you got political appointment, that you are the minister of this area, minister of interior, you are minister of defense, you are minister of finance, everybody is afraid. Even he was an ordinary man before, but once he becomes that minister, everybody is afraid. Why? Because he's wearing the name of the president of the government. He has that authority to punish, to sack, to appoint. He has that authority. When you see a military officer in duty, maybe in Europe people will not see that, but go to African countries, you see a military officer in uniform, everybody will be shaking. Not because the man is powerful, but because the state has given him that uniform, he becomes very powerful. When a police officer is not wearing his police attire, or maybe he's not not working in the criminal department, those people don't have special attire. But a police officer in duty wearing the police uniform, that uniform gives him special power. People start to fear. If you remove that uniform and wearing ordinary thing, nobody fears the person. That is what it means to work in somebody's name, a name of an authority. That's what is when we are delegated that power. So when Jesus said, in my name you will cast out devils, doesn't mean that you have to go be shouting. What is important is to believe in the gospel and know who you are and what Christ has given to you to do. That's all. You take that judgment. You take that decision. Because when somebody is working as a minister, he doesn't have to go and ask the president what to do. He knows what he's supposed to do. He said, in my name, cast out these devils. In my name, stand up against these serpents. In my name, bring the recovery to these places. So everywhere you speak, that should bring recovery or to bring restoration to a place, because you are going to repair those places. And people will say that, oh, prayer is nothing if you are not doing anything. Listen, for the Christian, if you really believe in the gospel, it's the word from your mouth that will perform. That word from your mouth will perform that divine thing. It's for divine means. Jesus said, the words I speak, my Father does the work. And no human being can do better than God. But John chapter 4 verse 10, Jesus said, the words I speak, it's not even myself, the Father in me that does the work. If you believe in me, what I do, you can also do. Let me tell you, what Jesus and God the Father can do, no human being can do it. People will say, for example, that, you see that the Christians are rather foolish. It's not because they are prayerful, that is why maybe they are poor and or they are lazy. What they are following is not the faith. That is why their prayer become useless. I give an example when I'm saying that religion and prayer is not the reason why Christians are poor and useless. By telling you that Chinese are Buddhists, they are religious and pray even better than Christians. Muslims are religious. They pray more than Christians. Jews, Hindus, and even atheists, they are all religious. The only thing for atheists is that atheists don't believe in the God you believe in. They believe in the God of Mammon. And they are all doing fine, even though they are using their own intelligence and wisdom. But let me tell you that what God can do, no human being can do it. So if we understand our faith and we are praying correctly, we have to perform better than every human being, than whatever Satan can help anybody to get. Because at least in the world that we find ourselves, people who are even more successful, it's not even their strength. It is some powers that they are following. We know people who go to some occults and get success for whatever they want to do. So if we go out there to do something, if we want to get any chance and get any results, first of all, it should come by the power working inside us. God power in us through our mouth. When Centurion asked Jesus to come to his house and tell him to speak the word, he knew that Jesus can go there and even lay his hands. But he said the word is enough, the Centurion. And Jesus said it's a great faith. Matthew chapter 8 from verse 5. Great faith, speak the word only, is what the man said. Jesus could lay hands, but he said, I don't need that one. Why should Christians still think that speaking in prayer alone is not enough? When the centurion said to Jesus, speak the word only, and Jesus says the great faith, and truly the man got the results. It's because we don't believe. That's why we think that we're to define that when you are not even doing anything, you think prayer can help you. Prayer alone can help you. We don't understand. That's why we think like that. We are made to believe like that. So, in the name of Jesus, every knee should bow means that you should understand that you have been delegated power. So you are walking here in the name of Jesus. And everything you say, Satan should know. When you have this mind in you, Satan is afraid of you. Because if you see any minister of government or head of institution or even a foreman, you are afraid of him. You make sure that you don't offend the person. You do whatever he's saying. Why? Because he carries a name. He's delegated a power in the name. That is what it means. Believe in the name of Jesus. Stay blessed.